everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Danielle, and today I want to share with you four things that I wish I would have done before I started buying luxury items, and four things that I wish I would have done as I continue to purchase items and grow my luxury collection. So whether you've never bought a luxury item in your life, whether you're thinking about it and wondering how you get started, whether you've just started buying luxury, or whether you've been buying luxury for a long time, I think these are important things to keep in mind and consider as you continue to build your collection and as you continue to look at buying luxury items. So I want to share with you before we get started my t-shirt. It says I hate lemon days. It's by the brand Agoldie, and I got it brand new with tags still attached from the website ThredUp. ThredUp, if you don't know, is a consignment resale website, and they have some great items. They have new items and items that are pre-loved, so you can get some great deals on there. This video is not sponsored in any way. I just really love getting fantastic deals, and I would definitely consider it a lemon day when we spend too much money on items that we end up not using or not really liking. So we want to avoid those lemon days at all costs. I thought this t-shirt was so cute. I'm really into graphic tees right now, so I just wanted to share that with you. I like being fun with my sense of fashion and my flair, and sometimes, honestly, I am not really dressed up. I don't wear a lot of makeup, so fashion is really personal. If you like talking about luxury or finding out ways that you can be a better version of yourself, then you're gonna love this channel. Whether you're a man or a woman, one unique thing about this particular channel is that I do have content on this channel for men and women. I wanna really make this a channel that really caters to both men and women in various different ways. So I hope, if nothing else, that I entertain you, that I offer you some advice. I also really want this to be an interactive community, so I'd love for you to share with me your ideas, the things you love, and your fashion sense, because I'd love to hear from you. So with that, let's go ahead and jump into the video. So the first thing I wish I would have done when I started to purchase luxury items before I bought anything, I really wish that I would have taken the time to really go through and clean my drawers and my closet. And as we know, there's a lot of good reasons why we should clean our closet. We all know those reasons. But as it relates to purchasing luxury items, we know that luxury items are not inexpensive. They are an investment. They are more expensive. So when you're looking at doing that, you want to make sure that the items that you actually have in your closet are items that you're currently wearing that you really like. When we look in our closet, we see items that we might like, but they might be items that we don't wear for whatever reason. Maybe they don't fit us properly. Maybe they're not really functional for our lifestyle. Maybe we're not big on the color, but it looks really pretty on the hanger. You have to be realistic about what you actually really are going to wear, what you actually really like. And you really want to make sure that when you're considering your next luxury purchase, you're not considering items that you have in your closet that you're not really going to use or wear. And so you might buy your next accessory or your next handbag based on items that you don't really wear, and then you're going to find that you don't really use it because in actuality, it doesn't really work with the clothing that you really wear or your lifestyle. So you really want to look at what you actually have in your closet that you're going to wear. The other thing about this is when you clean your closet will be neater and cleaner. You're going to have more space to store your luxury items properly in your closet if your closet is clean and not too cluttered. And that becomes really important because as we spend this money, we want to make sure that we're taking proper care of the items that we're investing in and that we're buying. So the second thing that I wish I would have done right away is I wish I would have formed a relationship with a client advisor or a sales associate at the brands that I was looking at purchasing from. And I think I didn't do this right away, largely because initially most of my purchases were made pre-loved because, as we know, these are expensive items. And I bought a lot of my items initially on the pre-loved market. But the second reason why I think I didn't is because I was a little intimidated. I think I kind of had this perception that people that worked with sales associates or client advisors were people that had a lot of money, that they were going to spend a lot of money. That's not necessarily the case. Now, just to clarify, a sales associate or client advisor is very different from a personal shopper or someone that you might see on social media that can source and get an item for you. A lot of those types of people do have fees attached to their services because that's what they do for a living. But a client advisor or a sales associate that actually works for the brand in a brick and mortar retail store is there to help you, and that's their job. By getting items through them, you're not going to pay any more than you would online, but there are some advantages to going that route. One of the first advantages is that they can really answer questions that you might have about an item. Let's say that you're looking at two separate items and you're really torn between which one you want to go for. They can really answer your questions, give you pros and cons, and give you advice regarding your purchase. The other reason is that sometimes when you order items online, there's a possibility that it could come and there might be something wrong with it. Maybe the glazing is cracked. Maybe the zipper is crooked. Maybe something is off with the item. Now, this is not to say that just because you use a sales associate or a client advisor that everything is going to be perfect and all of your purchases will be absolutely flawless. I'm not saying that, but there is a better chance that you will get an item that you want in really good condition because your sales associate or client advisor, especially if you ask them to, will really look your item over before they send it to you with a fine-tooth comb to make sure nothing looks off with the item. And if you want an item, like let's say you're ordering from Louis Vuitton and you would prefer your item to be, let's say, made in France rather than made in the USA, you can ask for that and they can look for that for you. So there are some advantages that way. The other thing is that they can let you know when new items are coming out or when there are special events or potentially sales or other events happening that you would want to know about that you might not otherwise find out about. The other thing is that I find that the packaging and the service is really nice when you work with a sales associate or client advisor. So I recently just started doing this very recently, and I really like it. It is worth the extra time you put in to source that relationship. A really good way to find a sales associate or client advisor if you don't have one is by joining a Facebook group that is a luxury Facebook group of the brand that you're looking to find a sales associate or client advisor for. So Facebook groups are a great way to get information, to really get some knowledge, and that's where I found my sales associate for Louis Vuitton. I really like her, she's great, and I really enjoyed working with her. Another way that you can do this is simply go online, look on the website, and call a store. Call a store and talk to someone and see if there is anyone at the store that would be able to help you that could become your client advisor or your sales associate. Now, I would really recommend when you look online to look for flagship stores. Flagship stores are going to be stores that are bigger. They're going to have more volume, which means they're probably going to have more items in stock than other stores might have. So that's another tip that I have for you. The third thing that I wish I would have done as I was growing my luxury collection is really consider my personal style and my lifestyle more, rather than getting really sucked into the moment, to social media, to what's really trendy and what's really popular, because what's really trendy and what's really popular may not be what's really realistic for you to wear in real life. Remember that what we see on social media may not be what your real life looks like. Now, I remember when I first started collecting luxury, I had this thought or this vision in my head. I was going to be attending all these events, and I really wanted handbags and items that were really catering to a lifestyle where I was dressing up a lot more, where I was going to a lot of events. And I purchased some items with that in mind, when in reality, that's not my life at all. Not at all. That's kind of what I envisioned, and I guess to be honest, in the beginning, I thought that people that purchase luxury items, that's how they live, that's what they did, but that's not really the case. I, in actuality, in real life, work at a gym. I'm a personal trainer. I wear workout clothes and sneakers literally 6 days a week. In fact, in a spirit of total transparency, I just got home from work, and here are my gym pants. So, yep, that's my lifestyle. Not the lifestyle that I thought I wanted to live in my head. And so when I purchased some items initially based off of this fantasy I had in my head about the kind of lifestyle that I wanted to have versus the lifestyle that I actually was living, and I didn't really consider my own sense of personal style, then I ended up buying items that I didn't end up really using that weren't really functional for my lifestyle. And in the end, I was fortunate to be able to sell these items, but sometimes you end up losing money and you lose time, and it just is kind of a waste of your time. And it can be kind of a letdown when you realize that you spend money and time on an item that you actually never really use. So really consider your personal sense of style. My personal issue issue with this was that I didn't really know what my personal sense of style was. One good way to figure that out, if you're like me and you don't really know what's my personal sense of style, I don't really feel like I have a sense of style, which is where I was probably about 3 years ago. I was just wearing gym clothes all the time and not really thinking like, oh, I have a personal sense of style. What you want to do is you want to look at celebrities that you admire that have a social media presence. And if there's someone that you really like the way they dress, whether you're a man or a woman, you can do this. You want to Google them, but after you Google them, you want to put in the words street style. The reason you want to put the words street style in after you Google the person is because it will show you how they wear the items that they're wearing in real life, in everyday living. And you're going to see examples of them dressing and wearing items in everyday life. And that's what you really want to see. You want to see how they dress when they're running errands. You want to see how they style certain items that you're interested in buying when they're just out living their life normally on a day-to-day basis. So that's one way that you can do that. And you can just try some things out. So this can be kind of a trial and error process. And you may not know initially what kind of handbags or what kind of accessories or what kind of belts or shoes fit in with your lifestyle or what you like or what's comfortable. And that's something that you learn over time. The fourth thing that I wish I would have done as I was starting to build my luxury collection and buy more pieces is I wish I would have done more research. I wish I would have thought about my lifestyle a little bit more, and I wish I would have considered resale value. And when I say this, I'm not saying that resale value is everything. I certainly don't buy handbags and accessories with the intent of selling them to try and make money. Absolutely not. Now, you might want to do that. It's not something I recommend you start doing right away when you're first starting, but that's not my intent, and that was never my intent. But when I say considering resale value and considering your lifestyle a little more, what I mean is that when you first start building a luxury collection, you may not know what you like. You may not know what your must-haves in a handbag or in certain accessories are. For example, when I was looking at buying my first luxury piece, I fell in love with a bag called the Chloe Marcy. And I will put a picture on the screen here. So you can see it's got this kind of boho chic kind of vibe, and I thought it was really cool looking, and I really, really lusted after that bag. Now, I didn't end up buying it, thankfully, and I'm really glad, because actually those bags don't hold their resale value very much at all. And that's not really my vibe. I don't really have a boho kind of vibe. The bag that I did end up getting as my first luxury purchase, which I'm so happy I did, and I believe that it's gonna be a forever bag in my collection because I love it, and whether it's in style or it's not, I will wear it, I will love it, is this bag. And this is a Christian Dior East West bag, and I'll put a picture on the screen. It's this really beautiful black lambskin leather bag with the silver hardware, and I just love it. I think it's very classic. I think it's very timeless. It was within my budget at the time, and I really, really liked it. And it is something that I can see myself wearing for a very, very long time, regardless of what the styles are, because I think it's more of a classic type of style and a classic color. And so that's something that I wish I would have done more, because I did purchase some other pieces that were more trendy in nature, and I didn't think about resale value, and I didn't think about how I was gonna style those pieces. That really comes through experience, and that really comes through trial and error and just trying different things out. So as you're learning and as you're figuring it out, you wanna make sure that you're investing in pieces that do have a relatively high resale value, that are more classic pieces that in case you don't like them or they don't work out for your lifestyle, you can kind of learn as you go without losing too much money. So that's the fourth thing that I wish I would have done as I was starting to build my luxury collection. Now, there's a lot more things probably I could think of that I wish I would have done, but these are my top four. I hope you found this video helpful. I hope you found it entertaining. I would love for you guys to subscribe to my channel. Hit that little red subscribe button down below. Ring my bell so you never miss a video. I do upload videos weekly. Thank you guys for joining me today. I look forward to seeing you in my next video. And remember, beauty begins the moment you decide to be yourself, and confidence is the most important accessory that you can wear.